Hey JV students, Miss Dowd here. Welcome to First Chapter Fridays, Episode 3. Our book this week is The Rise of Kyoshi. This is for fans of Avatar, The Last Airbender, the TV show. This is actually a prequel. If you like anime, you'll like this book. Even though it's not anime, it's told in a traditional story way. You'll still enjoy this book. If you like underdog stories, and of course, if you like fantasy. The series, this is the number one in the series, there's two books, has really excellent reviews on Goodreads. In fact, it's almost a 4.5, which is pretty high. So we're going to start our First Chapter Friday this week by reading the foreword by the creator. Any prequel story presents a unique challenge. Never mind one set in a fictional canonical universe like that of the Avatar, The Last Airbender. A common pitfall of prequels: since the reader already knows how things eventually turn out, they are one step ahead of the hero. Done well, however, a prequel can expand and deepen a beloved fantasy world by exploring its history and characters in new ways. This is the case with The Rise of Kyoshi. Readers familiar with the original Nickelodeon series might recall that Avatar Kyoshi was a legend, even among the impressive pantheon of avatars. But how did she become a woman dedicated to fighting injustice throughout the world? And why was she so feared by her enemies? These were the questions left unexplored. In my first talks with FC Yi, we discussed a few possible plots, but also asked ourselves, what kind of character is Kyoshi? What drives her? And what kind of events in her past could have caused her to develop into such a legendary figure? I didn't envy Yi the challenge of tackling these questions. I knew he'd have plenty within the conventions of an already established world, while simultaneously marking it with his own creative stamp. And the Avatar universe has no shortage of must-haves. First, you must have an avatar, the reincarnated being who holds the ability to manipulate or bend all four elements, who has a connection to the mysterious spirit world, and who deals with conflicts among the water tribes, earth kingdom, fire nation, and air nomads. The avatar can't do all this alone, and thus must also have a core group of teachers and friends, a team avatar, as we like to call it. Political conflict is always a must. Whether it's a world war or a revolution, the avatar inevitably ends up in the center of the fight before he or she is ready. And of course, there is never a shortage of epic bending battles. Though all avatars share certain rites of passage, such as mastering all four elements, each one must have a unique journey and face different personal and political challenges on their way to becoming a fully realized avatar. In The Rise of Kyoshi, we meet a young woman so unlike the legend she is to become that we wonder how she could possibly transform into such a remarkable figure. She's not a great earthbender. People don't even believe she's the avatar at the start of the book, a great consi on Yi's behalf, and one that provides the crux of the conflict for the entire novel. Entrusting another writer with a world and characters that I helped create is always fraught with anxiety for me. In the wrong hands, it can be a disheartening experience. But when I read The Rite of Kyoshi for the first time, I was immediately drawn into the story and entranced by its intriguing new characters and backstory. I was eager to read on to find out how Kyoshi would overcome all the obstacles in her way, and Yi throws plenty of them in her path. Working on this project with everyone involved has been a pleasure, and I couldn't be more excited about this incarnation of the Avatar universe. Michael Dante Z. Martino.
Available for checkout.